In this video, we're continuing on with the CUDA software, infinite geometry, free worksheet, the Pythagorean theorem, and its converse. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, picking up on the second page with number 9, our directions are to state if each triangle is a right triangle. And we know that if they're a right triangle, a squared plus b squared will equal c squared, where c is always the greatest length, since C is the hypotenuse. So let's get started with number 9. Our greatest length is 15, so that will be C. So let's make 9A and 12B, or vice versa. So for A squared plus B squared equals C squared, we'll have 9 squared plus 12 squared equal to 15 squared. If this is a right triangle, this will be true. 9 squared is 81, plus 12 squared, which is 144, does that equal 15 squared, which is 225? 81 plus 144 does indeed equal 225. So because they're equal, yes, this is a right triangle. And number 10, our longest side is 16, so that is C. So we'll make A 10, and b will be 2 times the square root of 39. So a squared, 10 squared, plus b squared, 2 times the square root of 39 squared, does that equal 16 squared? If it does, then this is a right triangle. 10 squared is 100, plus 2 times the square root of 39 squared is 156, because that's 2 squared, which is 4 times 39, since the square root of 39 times the square root of 39 is a positive 39. So 4 times 39 will give us 156. And does that equal 16 squared, which is 256? 100 plus 156 equals 256, and 256 is equivalent to 256. So yes, this is a right triangle. And number 11, our hypotenuse, C is 11, and then we'll make 9a, and the square root of 115 will be b. So a squared, 9 squared, plus b squared is the square root of 115 squared. Does that equal c squared, which is 11 squared? 9 squared is 81, and the square root of 115 is 115. Does that equal 11 squared, which is 121? 81 plus 115 equals 196, and 196 does not equal 121. So no, this is not a right triangle. And number 12, we can see that our hypotenuse is 48.5, and our side A can be 39, and B, that leg, will make 32.5. So 39 squared plus 32.5 squared, does that equal 48.5 squared? If that's true, then this is a right triangle. 39 squared is 1,521, and we're going to add that to 32.5 squared, which is 1,056.25. Does that equal 48.5 squared, which is 2,352.25? 39 squared plus 32.5 squared will give us 2,577.25, and that does not equal 2,352.25. And since those numbers are not equivalent, then no, this is not a right triangle. In number 13, it says, state if the three side lengths form a right triangle. So essentially, we're doing the same exact thing, except this time we're not given a diagram. But remember, C is always the greatest number. So in 13, our greatest number is 50.5. So this will be A, we'll make 49.5B, and C is 50.5. We could also make 10B, 49.5A, but remember, C is always the greatest, that's 50.5 in this case. So A squared, 49.5 squared plus b squared, which is 10 squared, does that equal c squared, 50.5 squared. 49.5 squared is 2,450 and 25 hundredths, so 0.25. 10 squared is 100, and 50.5 squared is 2,550.25. When I add 2,450.25 to 100, I get 2,550.25, which is equal to 2,550.25. Therefore, yes, in number 13, because a squared plus b squared equals c squared, this is indeed a right triangle. In number 14, our c is the greatest length of 15, so we'll make a 9 and b 12. So 9 squared plus 12 squared, does that equal 15 squared? 9 squared is 81, 12 squared is 144, does that equal 15 squared, which is 225? 81 plus 144 equals 225, and because 225 equals 225, then yes, this is a right triangle. In 15 and 16, we're to state if each triangle is acute, obtuse, or right, but we're still using the Pythagorean theorem. So you know that for a right triangle, a squared plus b squared will equal c squared. For an acute triangle, looking at the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared will be greater than c squared. And for an obtuse triangle, a squared plus b squared will be less than c squared. So let's apply this in number 15. C will be 17, since 17 is the greatest number out of 9, 12, and 17. And we'll make a 12 and b 9. So a squared plus b squared is 12 squared plus 9 squared. And I'm going to see if that's equal to c squared, which is 17 squared. If it's not equal, it's either greater than or it's less than. So then we'll be able to tell if it's acute or obtuse. 12 squared is 144 plus 9 squared is 81, and 17 squared is 289. 144 plus 81 is equal to 225, and 225 does not equal 289, but 225 is less than 289. So because a squared plus b squared is less than 289, this is obtuse. So in number 15, this triangle is not right, it is obtuse. In number 16, C is 20.1, we'll make A 9.6 and B 18. So A squared plus B squared, we're going to see if that equals C squared. If not, if it's greater than C squared, then it's acute. Although if A squared plus B squared is less than C squared, then, like in number 15, it would be obtuse. So A squared is 9.6 squared plus B squared, which is 18 squared, does that equal 20.1 squared? 9.6 squared is 92.16. 18 squared is 324, and 20.1 squared is 404.01. So 92.16 plus 324 will equal 416.16. And that is greater than 404.01. So let's look back at our formulas. If we have a squared plus b squared greater than c squared, that's going to be acute. So number 16, this triangle is acute. And lastly, on to number 17 and 18. Again, we're going to state if the sides form an acute, obtuse, or right triangle. This time, we're just not given the diagram. So in 17, we'll have A, B, and C. So A squared is 6 squared plus B squared, which is 2 times the square root of 55 squared. Does that equal C squared, which is 17 squared? 6 squared is 36 plus 2 times the square root of 55 squared is equal to 220, because that's 55 times 4. Does that equal 17 squared, which is 289? 36 plus 220 equals 256, and 256 is less than 289. So since a squared plus b squared is less than c squared, then this is obtuse. And lastly, number 18. However, before I go over the answer to this, please remember to click that subscribe button and like this video. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, in number 18, let's make 4.8b, 28.6a, and 29 we know is c since it's the greatest. So a squared is 28.6 squared plus b squared, which is 4.8 squared. Does that equal c squared, which is 29 squared? 28.6 squared is 817.96 plus 4.8 squared is 23.04. Does that equal 29 squared, which is 841? 817.96 plus 23.04, that equals 841. So since 841 equals 841, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, this is a right triangle. And with that, we finish out the Pythagorean theorem and its converse worksheet. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. And remember, like, subscribe, and share.